Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 1822, summarize worksheets with indirect. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jellin. Well, today I have two very similar questions sent in by two different people, so I'm going to attack this over two episodes. Andrew Z, trying to make a table by pulling data from other sheets. Is there a way to do this quickly? I've tried using the sheet name in a reference, even an absolute reference, but I'm unable to change the sheet name as a copy of this form of the data. So we're going to do that in episode 1822. Tomorrow in 1823, David from Fort Myers had the same problem, but his total row is on a different row on each worksheet. So we'll do that tomorrow. Similar question, but a little bit different. So here we have worksheets for AT&T. The total is always in row 1. Citigroup, Exxon, Ford, General Electric, General Motors, Walmart. And we want to build a summary back here. So the first thing we're going to do is we're just going to build the first formula. Type an equal sign, go click on the AT&T tab, point to cell E1, and I'll press F4 two times to lock down the row but not the column, and then press Control Enter. And the formula that we get here is an equal sign, apostrophe, the sheet name, another apostrophe, exclamation point, and then the column at $1. Parts of this need to change as we copy the formula through, and the particularly tough part is the customer name, and it points to a different worksheet. So we're going to use a function, an obscure function called equal indirect. And what indirect does, it says, I want you to analyze what's inside the indirect, and when you're done analyzing that, it's going to look exactly like a cell reference. And once you get that, go out to that cell reference and return the value. Alright, so we need to build a cell reference that looks exactly like this. And so the first thing is that apostrophe. I'm going to put the apostrophe in quotes. So there's quote, apostrophe, quote, and then an ampersand. After the ampersand, we're going to point to cell D2, and I'll press F4 one, two, three times to make sure that we always point back to D. And then another ampersand, and we'll delete. I'll put a quote, and then the closing apostrophe, and the exclamation point. Alright, so we've now gotten up to the point where we need to point to column E. Boy, and there are probably a lot of different ways to do this, but the way that comes to my mind right here, right now at 5 in the morning, is ampersand, the mid of A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, comma, the current column, in this case that's 5, comma, 1, will return us the column letter that we're currently in. We might be able to do this using the address, but this is the way I want to go. And then, quote, the $1, closing quote, and closing parentheses. All right, so we have that formula, and it's returning the exact same value. Let's just take a look and see what this formula is doing. If we take that whole bit there and press F9, it is, oh, that's funny, it's returning an array, returning something that looks exactly like that. And as we copy it throughout, and I go, for example, over here, and press F9, you'll see that it's now pointing to Ford in apostrophes, exclamation point, G, $1. So we're being clever, we're using formulas to build a formula, in essence, and it is returning the correct value throughout. So for Andrew, this indirect, because he's always pointing to the same row number every time. In my case, it's row 1. In his case, it's probably something different. This simple, well, I don't know if it's simple, but this indirect will solve the problem. Now tomorrow, episode 1823, David, his totals are in a different spot every time, so we'll take a look at how to solve that. Alright, well, hey, I want to thank Andrew and David for sending those questions in, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.